Hey, Woody.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Sure, let's go with that.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, totally.
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing
Burns,
shorts.
Get up there.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very,
what the fuck?
You know, PC or whatever they say.
Sure, okay, good enough.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man.
Hey!
Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Tuxedos.
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
I really don't.
Oh, come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like.
Whatever's comfortable.
Good jacket
works.
I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Buckle Barn!
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do.
I'd
now tell
go
me
for
about
blue.
Your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Some dork that probably wouldn't catch your attention.
A pretty thick beard.
Oh. Have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
Alright, perfect.
My beard's actually not very thick. It's like
eyes.
like a shaggy beard.
I'm drawing you.
Soinks!
No.
Kind of shaggy.
What?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
I mean, what's the big deal?
Your eyes, tell me.
Yeah, that's probably true.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
I mean,
well,
people usually think I'm much younger than I am.
Okay, got it. Thank
I
you,
like
Henry.
I like that idea though.
You
distinguished.
Get what you need?
Yeah, I could
absolutely.
Do that.
Absolutely.
But now people think I'm like really, really young. And I'm almost 30. That's a scary thought.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next?
Oh, he's my turtle!
Well, you've been the one
hey,
doing
Shelly.
That for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st
so cute.
And call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to
no!
you.
No!
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
Yeah, well said.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
Why, thank you.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Fine. Oh. Sandwich, make
Hello,
me
Henry.
Strong.
Have
Did I just
nice
eat the rest
Sunday?
Of that in one bite?
Not too
Ooh.
Bad. I could get used to it out here.
Oh, it's pretty.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing.
Got
parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Shit.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Yeah, didn't fucking do anything.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead,
what? No! No, why would you not say
should
anything?
Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
The fuck?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the
okay,
cops.
Okay, but whether you want to talk to the cops
Me
or
neither.
Not, it's still
All right, Henry,
missing
thanks.
People.
Enjoy the sunset.
Great.
Henry. Henry, wake up.
I don't wanna.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
No.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Wait, what?
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
Oh, you sound British.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I mean, she's supposed to be Australian, but she sounds British, she does.
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know.
That's great, Henry. Really great.
Did I miss something?
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
No, we're just gonna gloss over that. Okay. Whatever, man. Okay, so I'm going there.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky.
Good stuff that will make sure that it keeps.
Six prunes a day. Six. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana.
Ah, okay.
Production.
That might explain it. Psychopath.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet.
That explains a lot. I was wondering about that.
Maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier.
Javier!
He was incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper.
Oh, is he one of those
dated
sexy Latinos?
For almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. This was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose.
Okay, that sounds responsible.
Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette. And, for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was
kind of
feel
bad about making a joke
like
now.
That, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied, and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about
that's
it.
That's kind of escalating. That's kind of not cool.
And, for some reason, I wanted you to know.
Fair enough.
I figured you've told me so much about you. So, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
I mean, at least you admit it. I kind of feel bad for her now. But I have food, so it's okay. Do I get to actually encounter these other lookouts?
I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Yeah, fucking of course, yeah, just mine. Hello.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
We're not concerned about that?
In. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression.
Looks like a pretty big fire.
I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer.
Yeah.
And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny, or something practical, or a little risque when coming up with them.
They seem kind of laid back for, you know, I mean, it's our job to be Firewatch.
Maybe we call it the Flapjack Fire.
Flapjack.
Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack Fire.
I like how just immediately tagged it with a name.
Cooking accident or something. So there's this creek down the hill, and you know what my favorite
thing to do is... Keep up the good work, Burns.
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day.
That sounds nice.
And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot...
That sounds really nice.
I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe.
You ever been out by, like, a creek or something like that? It's just this really nice, refreshing coolness to
it.
I've had a bad time with tequila.
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
I actually have no alcohol to turn on, so...
Are you looking at the fire?
Tequila probably can't...
No, I'm not.
Should I?
We should.
Okay. I was gonna go investigate the fire. The Flapjack Fire.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
I know that feeling. I love fire.
Yeah. I'm glad you're here.
Still doesn't seem like the appropriate response for fire watchmen.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Sure.
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, I like Delilah.
Talk to the lookouts as much as I talk to you.
She's got a good sense of humor.
Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer.
Yeah.
Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there.
I'm married.
It'd be nice to be near somebody.
Married?
We could talk without these radios. We could,
married?
You know. It'd be nice to be close to someone.
Still married!
Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away?
Married.
You're going fishing without a license?
Fuck yeah.
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
No, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
I'm working for you people.
I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There's a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Problem bear? Fuck that!
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
You're welcome. Yeah. Going fishing. Got my rod in my hand, I'm going fishing. But not that kind of rod, friend. Going fishing. Do I actually get to go fishing? What the hell?
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something I can call it.
Okey-doke. What did that say?
What does that say? Shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried.
Shit just kind of got really creepy.
You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo?
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Shithouse.
Get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
What? Fuck! What?! Hey, hope you enjoyed the video.
Oh, what's happening next?
But no, seriously, the intrigue's about to ramp up hardcore. If you want to see more videos I've done, you can click up here, and if you enjoyed the video, please click that like button. Click here to subscribe, and if you're already subscribed, please help grow the channel by sharing it with a friend. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.